Hello everyone, in this video for the chapter elements of group 13, 14 and 15 I am going to talk about the chemical properties of group 13, 14 and 15 elements and some allotropes. Now the reactivity towards oxygen or air. Group 13 elements used to react with oxygen present in the air as well as nitrogen also to form their respective oxide and nitrides. And when we are heating this element with air, then only we are going to get the oxide and nitride. Here the general formula of oxide is E2O3 and general formula of nitride is En. For example, group 13 element like aluminium, if it is heated with oxygen or air, it will form Al2O3 and AlN respectively by the reaction of oxygen and nitrogen. Now group 14 elements. Group 14 elements on heating in air or oxygen, they used to form two types of oxides, that is EO and EO2, according to the stable oxidation state and availability of oxygen. Group 15 elements. The elements of group 15 on heating in air, they used to form two types of oxide, E2O3 and E2O5. For example, if a phosphorus, which is a tetraatomic, when P4 is heated with oxygen, it may form P4O6 or it may form P4O10. Similarly, arsenic, it will turn up into A4O6 on heating with oxygen. And bismuth, on reaction with oxygen, it will form bismuth oxide, which is Bi2O3. If we see this table, the nature of oxide of group 13 element is boron is forming boron oxide, which is acidic in nature. Aluminium and gallium oxide are amphoteric. Indium and thallium oxide are basic in nature. If we talk about group 14 oxide, carbon dioxide, it is acidic. Silica, it is acidic. Germanium oxide, it is acidic. And stannic oxide and lead oxide, these two oxides are amphoteric. We talk about group 15. Nitrogen is forming acidic oxide. Phosphorus is forming acidic oxide. Arsenic oxide is amphoteric. Antimony oxide is amphoteric. And bismuth oxide is basic. Reaction with water. Most of the elements of group 13, 14 and 15 remain unaffected by water. Aluminium used to react with water on heating only to form its hydroxide and hydrogen gas is liberated. Whereas tin used to react only the steam, or you can say gaseous water, to form its oxide and hydrogen gas. Lead remain unaffected by water due to the formation of protective film over the oxide. We see the equation, aluminium is heated with water to give aluminium hydroxide and hydrogen gas, and tin is reacting with the steam to give you stannic oxide and hydrogen gas. Now, reaction with halogens. All the elements of group 13 react directly with halogens to form trihalides. Thallium is an exception, which used to form monohalide, which is TLX. We talk about group 14, they used to react directly with halogens to form tetrahalides. The heavy elements germanium, lead form dihalides as well, and stability of dihalides increases down in a group. The ionic character of halides also increases steadily down in a group. Elements of group 15 reacts with halogen to form two series of halides. They may be EX3 and EX5, that means trihalides or pentahalides. The pentahalides possess more covalent character due to the availability of vacant d orbitals of the valence shell for bonding. Nitrogen, it is there in the second p here, so it does not have any d orbital in its valence shell. So nitrogen does not form any pentahalide. Trihalide of the group 15 elements are predominantly covalent except BiF3 or bismuth trifluoride, The only stable halide of nitrogen is nitrogen trifluoride. Now, catenation. Catenation is the property, we can say it is a self-linking of atoms of an element by a covalent bond to form long chains and rings, and we can say this property of formation of chains, bulky compounds called catenation. The catenation tendency of an element depends upon the strength of the bond. And in case of 14 group, carbon used to show maximum tendency for catenation because of carbon to carbon strong bond. And to break this carbon to carbon bond, we require energy which is 348 kilojoule per mole. The order of catenation of group 14 element is carbon is maximum. In case of catenation, it used to have so many molecules due to the catenation property. Then silicon, germanium and tin tendency are exactly equal. Lead does not show any catenation property. Allotropy. When a solid element exists in different crystalline form with different physical properties are called as allotrope. And the property is called allotropy. And different physical property, we can say they have different color, different density, melting point, boiling point, etc. And the phenomena is called allotropy, and the individual crystalline form are called allotropes. For example, diamond, graphite, fullerene, carbon black, kajal, these are the different allotropes of carbon. Elements such as boron, bismuth, silicon, etc. of group 13, 14 and 15, they used to exhibit the allotropy, or they used to have allotropes.